One of the world's most famous violinists, Julian Rachlin, presents the film Noseland in Vilnius International Film Festival, Cinema Spring in Vilnius. Principal participants are Julian Rachlin, Alexei Igudesman, John Malkovich. What it means to you empathizing with the role of producer?
What it means to me is that I was running a music festival in Dubrovnik for 12 years, and it was an idea which I had together with my friend Alexei Igudesman, who is himself a wonderful musician but also a comedian and also loves to make movies. He's a very multi-talented personality, and it was my idea together with Alexei to come up with a movie about my festival in Dubrovnik, but it should be a... The idea was to make a different kind of documentary about a classical music festival. Because when you normally watch documentaries about classic music festivals, you fall asleep in the first 5 to 10 minutes because they are rather boring. And we wanted to set a counterpoint, especially for the young children or for the teenagers, for the twins, because classical music needs more young people. We want to see much more youth at the concerts. And so we want to show that the musicians, we are not all boring and uninteresting people, and we are not all the time serious. We are very serious about the music, but outside of the music, so to speak, behind the curtain, we are very crazy, funny personalities. And Alexei and myself, with this movie, we want to show that we can have a lot of fun and that we are very approachable. And so we hope that through this movie, the appeal to young people will result in them visiting our concerts in the future.
You are a violinist born in Vilnius, today playing in the world's major stages with the world's leading orchestras and conductors. You became the second UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador in Lithuania. Could you please tell more about your UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador activities and the project?
Absolutely. As a UNICEF ambassador, it's our obligation and task to speak about the importance that this wonderful organization, the importance of it in the world. And the truth is that UNICEF stands for the rights of children, and there is millions of children in need of help on our planet. And through my profession, through my musical journeys all over the world, I get to see a lot of poverty. I get to see a lot of, a lot of things which maybe other people do not see. You know, I went to Cambodia, to Vietnam, I went to India. I visit these countries which have a tremendous, tremendous need of help, and especially the children who have no hope for a childhood in decency. There is a lot of problems with AIDS, with drugs, with prostitution, children prostitution. There is a lot of issues where UNICEF focuses, a lot of different projects. And I was very lucky to be introduced to UNICEF by my friend, the actor Sir Roger Moore. People know him from his films as 007, James Bond. And he has been a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador for many, many years, I think for around 40 years. And through my friendship to him, I learned more and more about this organization. And what I do is I speak out for UNICEF, for the rights of children, because I have access to the media. So I have the possibility on all my travels to talk in television, radio, magazines, in interviews, for social media, social network. And this is one side of my work, to talk to the media about UNICEF. And the other side of the work is to arranging special gala concerts where all the proceeds go to UNICEF. So where we, so the fundraising, where all the ticket prices and all the artists give their fees to UNICEF for a special cause. And 3 years ago, we did a wonderful project here in Vilnius at the Opera House, where the goal was, it was a musical evening, sort of a gala concert. And the ticket prices were very high, so it was very expensive to get a ticket, but we sold out the whole opera house, and the goal was to give the money to a project that UNICEF Lithuania had with Afghanistan, and the goal was to raise money for one school to be built in Afghanistan. But we sold so many tickets and we fundraised so much money that we actually opened two schools in Afghanistan. So, I mean, this is the work that I do for UNICEF, and I'm very honored to be named Goodwill Ambassador for this wonderful organization.
Your family showed humanity in the darkest times of Holocaust.
I know from what my parents told me. Yeah. My mother, the mother of my mother, lost her first husband in the ghetto, and she herself was saved by a Catholic woman here in Vilnius who was hiding her. And so, in a way, my family is very directly affected by the Holocaust, and I think it's really important, whatever we can do, never to forget the past and to hopefully for such tragedy never to reoccur in history. So, of course, I'm very grateful to whoever helped my grandmother, because otherwise then my mother wouldn't be alive and I wouldn't be alive. So
you were born in Vilnius. Did your parents tell you about a unique Jewish cultural heritage in Lithuania?
Well, I know that practically all the Jews were killed, so there was nobody left. I mean, we know that historically the Jewish people, not only in Lithuania, but also in Poland, but actually all over Europe or the world, were also in Austria, which is my home, they were in the leading roles in medicine, in, you know, lawyers, directors of banks, and of course artists. And many of them had to leave their professions, and we know historically about so many tragic cases. There was a great amount of composers who had unfortunately to die in the concentration camps and so on. So this dark point of human history, maybe the darkest of human history, nobody will ever be able to repair that. But our obligation is for the young people to be aware of the history and to always be reminded. I think it's very, very important.
Pesach, known as in English as Passover, is one of the most commonly observed Jewish holidays. Where is your Seder today?
Today my Seder... I must tell you that my parents, although we are Jewish, my parents, we never practiced the Jewish traditions. So in your eyes, we are very bad Jews. But I am invited to Seders every year. This year I cannot go because of my professional reasons. I have concerts and travels, and today I'm talking to you. But I think the Jewish traditions are wonderful. It gives incredible joy to people, to family, the way that the Jewish people keep their traditions. And I have a lot of very close friends to me who, you know, practice Shabbat every week and who do all the celebrations. And I love to visit. And last year I was 2 days doing the whole Seders, and it was quite amazing to see. And they have a lot of joy.
Would you like to say a basic greeting to all Jews in Lithuania, warm wishes for your loved ones on Pesach?
Absolutely. I wish them happiness, joy, health, and that all their dreams will come true and everything what they want to achieve. So with their family's support, with God's help, and with a lot of